What exciting times. There was a power outage. As if today hasn't already been exciting enough, right? Then, suddenly, that transpired. And of course, I hadn't saved the game. Let's see how far back the autosave takes us. 20 minutes ago, huh? Let's see how this looks. I don't know whether I'm going to be able to salvage last video, or I might have to try downloading one of Beam's VODs that'll be in cruddier quality. But, power outage. The heavens have aligned to prevent me from finishing this damn run. Okay. That's not too far back. Okay. It was before the mercantilism failure? No, I certainly adopted mercantilism a long time ago, Maze Mouse. Like, it's definitely running that. My cities are set to produce wealth and they've got levies done. I don't think I had them set to go that way. Oh, whatever. That was an alternate universe. Whatever, the future is now different. Welcome to the new future, everyone. Yay, new future. Why am I now getting tutorial messages? Excuse me? What the hell happened to my settings? So all of my settings just decided to get fragged? Like, the game crashing because my power flickered has now reset my settings. Okay, it turned off quick moves, quick combat. Alright, yeah, sure. I think I had this set off. Alright. I think I had those things switched set off for the automated worker shit, so okay. You know what? Fuck it. Fine. You can stay at 2. I don't even care anymore. Are your settings okay? Yeah, you look fine. Yeah, just my settings profile ends up getting corrupted. What the hell? Technology? I know it's the warp. The warp is interfered. Man, this is... From 2 weeks ago, where my computer decides that it wants to take off into outer space, to now what's happened today during this fucking... I'm just trying to finish a game of Civilization 4. That's all. It shouldn't be that damn hard. The mind reels. Oh, now he dies in this reality. A fucking course. I'm not bitter. There's other settings I need to turn back on. There we go. Can't draft because I don't have enough culture there to draft. That's fine. Okay. Just another day in paradise, everyone. My viewer count. This is tragic. Oh, I mean, why not, right, Mr. Grenadier Man? Okay. We can do this. This can be done. We have the technology. We can make the magic happen. Okay, you don't really have any convenient complaint or excuse about getting an email notification now, considering how I did just go live, you know, 11 minutes ago, okay? That's just, right? They did it, right? Yeah. That's correct. This city's starving. Well, might not be my damn problem. We'll go ahead and whip the Jewish temple there. Okay, what other option do I need to flip to get this game to stop sass-mouthing me by saying, "Hey, you want tutorial help, right? Load failed. Profile... Sure. Of course, why didn't I think of that? So it switched me to a new profile, I guess, because the old profile, for whatever reason. Unit cycling, it's no unit X. Not that. Minimize pop-ups? No. No. Advisors pop-up, SIDS tips? There we go. That'll be fine. At least it steps on. Got another one of you, huh? I'll keep you there. Let's see here. Alright. Let's go ahead and roll out. We'll take everyone but you three. Okay. Time for us to take this city. We didn't have enough cannons to, we didn't have enough cannons to really weaken down those numbers. That's okay. We'll just rebuild. We got ourselves another holy city. We also got the obsoleted Stonehenge and another military academy, and I have a dog. Dog. Right now's a bad time, dog. Other dog, right now's a bad time. Today. Good Christ, man. What the fuck is today? Other than Hell Day. Fucking alternate reality Hell Day here. I can't fucking believe this shit. I'm so close to snapping right now. Stalers. Yeah. I'll keep that in mind. Just want to finish this fucking game now. Goodness. Now, don't tell me I'm losing my connection to the fucking Inja servers now. Beam, don't you fucking start conspiring against me to fucking finish this shit too. I hate animals. I fucking hate animals. I want to burn every animal to the ground. Just burn them and feast on their bodies. That's all I want to do. Just want to burn them. That's all. Just an abattoir of animal bodies. Just puppies as far as the eye can see. And kitties. And little penguins, too. All of them burned. That's the only way we can have good things in life anymore. No, I don't want to stop a war. Okay, a trebuchet attacked me. That's reasonable. Of course, it would want to soften up my units. I don't understand how it gets a free withdrawal like that, but okay. Of course, it could have picked a better stack to attack, but such is life. This day. There have been better days. There have so been better days. It's gonna be one of my top 10 greatest achievements while recording and broadcasting if I manage to put this all together. Let's go ahead and just keep this damn trash city. Of course, my number keys that have, like, the buildings that I want to build that were saved there so I could just quickly queue them up. Of course those are gone, too. Alright. Of course they are. Hello. Hello. Now's not a good time. Welcome. Welcome. Welcome, everyone. Welcome to Civilization 4. Just trying to finish a game. That's all I want to do. I'm gonna finish a game and I'm gonna go sob into my pillow. Yeah, Chromos. You're not the only one to indicate that. It's something that I'm going to be, Well, it's been put on the list of features, we'll say. Features that I don't like on Beam. It is a list of some size today. There's some girth to it. That's all I really got to say about that right now. Go ahead and draft a few units. And I guess I better just go ahead and save, because it's been one of those days. It's a pretty good day, folks. Until I sat down and decided that I wanted to try and play Civilization 4 today. It was that moment that everything changed. That was the day the music died. Wait. I beg your pardon? I told you to save detailed city info. I lost cannons. Where did I lose those? Oh. Hmm. Of course. Of course there would be units that would... Civilization 4 AI has map hack. They can see where all units are positioned at any given time. They have no trouble with it. So me trying to run units using this version of pathfinding has resulted in me losing two of my precious cannons. That's okay. That's fine. Just a minor setback. No big deal. Look at how obnoxious this culture is. Ugh. All right. This city. What is this city good for? I guess it's a city. We'll go take the city, guys. The city is a city. All right. This routing thing that you guys wanted to do didn't quite work out. And I must say I'm a little displeased. Take that route. If you will. I think, the AI pathing, yeah. Surrey of Armin starting to build railroads in his territory now, which means when I do go to war with him, that's going to be more obnoxious. He's going to be able to move around pretty quickly. You know I don't damn give care about a single follower count. Come on here. Although maybe it is a sign of the end times, right? Hopefully this city doesn't revolt from me. It's a pretty good risk to do so, though, because culture borders have expanded so far into eating that one. It'd be nice to find a position to attack Surrey of Armin that wasn't so enshrouded by his culture. As it stands, it'll take me multiple turns to reach one of his cities. Regrettable, but... Ugh. This game's been rough, man. Shit. We need another round of cannons. Look at all that gold we're losing. Ugh. We are soaking in war weariness, too. That's not bad. It's +5 unhappiness from We Demand Emancipation. I can't give you emancipation. Like, I would understand you being pissed if I could. It's literally impossible for me to emancipate you. I don't actually know how to emancipate you. I don't. I can't. It's fucking literally impossible. It requires democracy. We don't have democracy. Why do you want to be emancipated? There is no democracy here. We want to be free. Oh, okay. How do you propose we do that, hotshot? Where did we lose those cannons? Alright, we lost a rifle somewhere. He's just straight up ran into that. Okay. Sure. No, don't go that way. I guess you can go that way, though. Meh. Okay. His next most powerful city, I imagine, is Chichen Itza. We're going to go for that. Take the waiting off Bacall. That's right, you. Never mind the fact that I can't fucking research it. Well, I mean, I could slowly work towards democracy. It's technically true. That's... okay, sure. Okay, boss. We can do that. We'll place there, just for you. Same low price. You're still starving. You're shrinking. That's not good. Get that theater. That's probably the thing I should actually be building in these places first. Truth be told. Theater for culture. Okay. What do we lose this time, boss? Alright, you're... Bacall has decided that he wants to trade units with me. Okay. You may find this hard to believe, folks, but trading units with me in my position is a bad idea. Seeing as though I can rapidly outproduce him. But we can keep trading. That's okay with me. Okay. If you want to get with me, there's some things you gotta know. I like my beats fast and my bass down low. Yeah, we'll go over that. Then we'll go after Mayapan. I mean, Mayapan's gonna be a... this city, like, really all these cities next to Mansa Musa's culture are gonna be pretty damn rough. Courtesy of all the cultures just gonna come flooding in. I guess I'm just killing everyone. Like, this is what's happening. I'm killing everyone. I guess we're doing this thing. My people just want to know peace and emancipation. Alright. What did I lose? I'm curious. What was that? By a grenadier. Okay. Yeah, sure. The unit trade continues. Sure, I'll poach that. Research is coming back online as I finish another round of cannons. Yeah, I'm gonna go after Suryavarman next. He's the second most powerful now. And he's in my way, bruh. What does he have for technology? He can research assembly line for infantry. That's bad. Only 3 cannons, huh? That's bad. Well, we lost a few along the way. I guess we'll just have to get over it. Right? Yeah. Losses. Disgusting. We'll build those things next. Are we still continuing to do this trade? Okay. Yeah. Don't you try and one for one me, game. Okay. With that in mind, why don't we leave behind some defenders? How long would it take for us to get there if we didn't include you? Okay. That's probably good enough force to take that city. He says, not really for sure if it's actually good enough force to take that city, but he's willing to try and give it the benefit of the doubt. Do I care about cleaning up these little cities? I just want to beat up Bacall. Want to beat up Bacall to the point where he's just not a threat to me in this game any longer. So if I take this city, and then sweep over these, and leave them with these two. Yeah. See, my intel says he's got 10, huh? That can't be right. How could he have 10? Does he have, like, other junkers around? Let's see. 9, 8, 7. What? How do you... I'm looking at the wrong person. God damn it, Grimith. So many, like, bluish colors. Alright, he's got 5 cities, yeah. And he would almost give me everything in exchange for peace. But almost everything's not the same as everything. I know, riveting knowledge, right? Almost everything's not the same as everything, you understand? Alright, you guys just all fucking camp out. Hold a powwow or some shit. Okay. We don't have any cannons in this deck at all. Ugh. Hideous. Only got 3 in this deck. Yeah, I guess I'm gearing up for a war against Chimera now. I'm going to use his railroads to get me in better position for this war. That doesn't mean I couldn't possibly lose some shit along the way, though. Where's another Great Hammer City? Hell if I know. This city could be as good as any other. So much unhappiness. City's just starving. Is there anything I could really build to get you guys happiness? I guess I could build, like, a theater or some shit. Oh, wow. That's gross. -7 unhappiness. All that war weariness. That is gross. I've been at war for too long in this game. There will be no peace. Only an eternity of carnage and slaughter. Game's like, yep. Eternity of carnage and slaughter. You got it. I'll take these 2 cities. I'll just leave Bacall with 2 cities. I mean, in all honesty, like, what kind of profitability am I going to get out of, like, these junkers, though? Other than his borders no longer pressing up against these cities. That's probably a good argument, yeah. Folks continuing to argue and harangue about various player types. In the chat. Not really burning it to Grimith. No, well, far I didn't blob out of control. This was all well-executed and necessary warfare to get this far. And I'm still not, you know, guaranteed to win this damn game. first. Okay. I tell you what, Bacall. Like, as obnoxious as this is, I kind of want to switch gears here. How many cannons do I have? Still 21. How many rifles do I have? More elephants all scattered around defending various things. I could definitely use more military units. I'd like to cut into Surrey of Arvin Cities next. If need be, I can always come visit Bacall later. Yeah. Okay, Bacall. Tell you what, buddy. I think you learned your lesson now. You would give me that, huh? Well, what if I went scientific method instead? I don't care about the city. What is that city, anyway? It's that city. That city doesn't give me anything. I want this, I want this, and I want this. And I want your gold. You can keep the theology. Good. I do not feel obliged to know free man shall be taken in interest and dowry in any other way. And we'll switch to free market now. We'll lose out on that bonus specialist, but I think that'll be okay. And of course we have oil in our territory, why wouldn't we? Okay. Surrey of Arvin's culture is just gonna all over this shit. But such is life. We're finally at peace. Mercifully at peace. Everyone producing wells. We're gonna need a levy out. We're gonna need a jail out of ya. Yeah, a levy. Okay. We got a ton of gold right now, and we're gonna use that to grab the railroad. So we can work on that shit all the live long day, baby. Okay. You guys. Except for two of you. Come here. You fortify and defend. I'm gonna want a defensive unit there. And you three come over here. I'm gonna want defensive units here, so you four move there. Defensive units, take those. That seems like a really fucking ass backwards bit way to get there, but that's the way it goes. This border is so thin. That city right there. Go ahead and draft in that city. Let's see here. Yep, fortify you. Because we could use an extra defender for sure. Nice to be able to have happiness in these cities once again, though. It's pretty comforting. Okay, time to go back to drafting. Even though there's plenty of unhappiness in my cities. These jails, by the way, are going to help with that. Jail reduces war weariness, because we throw the sons of bitches in prison. And it feels as if we all have done a great right in the world, once we accomplish that goal. Okay. Am I brave enough to try a two-pronged assault on Surrey of Arvin? I don't know. Need to gather what remains of my armies. We'll have to see. I've got units far-flung scattered across the atmosphere. I know, sorry, Varman, man. I mean, at least he ain't Joel, but damn, he's still obnoxious. What city's doing okay in happiness? Out of curiosity, boss. I'm asking for a friend. That I can also draft from. You. Good. Let's see, if I try attacking from this angle, 1, 2, 3 turns. 1, 2, 3 turns. I just don't know how strong he is. I don't think I'm going to get that information in time. Can see demographic 1642, and that's going to rapidly accelerate. I tell you what, I'm going to put all of my weight there in the Surya Varman, as he's putting so much weight into me. And we'll see what happens. I might try 2-pronged assault. Make the war a little quicker. Still large front. But it's important for me to eliminate these cities so that the culture doesn't oppress these new cities that I've taken. Otherwise, there's no real value or merit to me having captured them. Other than me just knocking a certain asshole in the dirt here. Damn. Not really much in the way of trade ships at all. I'm just trying to catch up. Surya Varman and Hammy there are just trading out of control. Just rapidly wheeling and dealing. Okay. Gotta keep that in mind, folks. As I expected, Mansa Musa cut his research slider quite a number of turns ago. He is less than 100 turns from winning the game. And that might be better if he accelerates. So within the next 100 turns, I'm going to have to go knock on his door and pay him a visit and say, "What's up? What's up, Mansa Musa? How's it going, man? Are you ready to die? I hope you are. That's about what's about to happen. I told you guys to go over there. I need you to go over here. We need to assemble the fleet. And thanks to Surya Varman's railroads, we're going to start setting those up ourselves too. Our workers have a lot of ground to cover though. And I'm probably going to lose some of those workers. A tragedy. We demand emancipation! How about I demand you shut the fuck up? Surya Varman going to be someone I want to completely eliminate? I certainly wouldn't mind him keeping that city so I could get his text from him. If I had vassal states enabled, this would certainly make conquest much easier, but I don't have vassal states enabled. There we go, all that obnoxious culture just straight into my face hole. Like, thanks. It took a few turns for it to register, but now it's all just there. It's there, in my face. Okay. I'm plotting war right now, folks. I have enough on my hands right now. These are some good hands. Yeah, buddy. Okay. Mansa won't trade anything with me. He's being rude. Mansa Moose is being rude. Bang. I do need more of a military. That's probably true. This war is going to cost lives. My people are like, please, stop the violence, Grimith, please. And I'm like, I'll think about it. This is also giving my units time to heal, although these borders are very exposed. I should probably draft like a military unit or two and just shunt them in there. Just like a paper-thin defense, you know? Like, oh, yep, totally well defended, boss! In fact, we'll do that. No, surely honest engines. We would never lose this city. Nope. Shit. What do I want to draft from around here? That'll be fine. I got a lot of units down here. Don't. No, I raised that city. Right. I forgot. Why would there be a soundboard? I actually do want to make many of these local recordings enjoyable. And focused on the gameplay at hand, such as this. Machine guns now. Ugh. They're not bad, plus 50% versus gunpowder units. I'm probably going to end up running into those whenever I attack Suri of Varman. Those are painful to deal with. Hopefully he doesn't build too many. I've got a long history with Suri of Varman in my various games. I think there's like a screenshot, like in the Civ Fanatics forum years back, there was like a game, a map as Charlemagne that was really rubbish and had really poor land that I played and won. And my big fight was against Suri of Varman. When he had so many fucking like fighters and bombers, and I'm marching in with like fucking rifles and cannons, and then infantry and cannons, and then infantry on artillery. Good times, Suri of Varman. You remember? I remember. Of course I did. Of course. Absolutely, of course. Of course I won that. How could I not? Damn. Wouldn't have enough votes to win the AP. A pity. I mean, Hammurabi, I think plus 8 or plus 9 is the border. I mean, he just likes me just enough. He's not going to like me so much, though, whenever I declare war on Suri of Varman, because that's coming. You better believe it is. Ah, Wang Khan doesn't even... Like, Wang Khan's one city doesn't even have Judaism in it. Wouldn't it be funny if I went for, like, a mid-1800s AP victory? I tell you what... Jewish missionary. Or we're not in any particular hurry for that one. Alright, we're not doing so bad with technology now, even though our cities are poorly configured for it. Tell you what, all cities producing wealth... I'm no longer going to put those emphasis as their foci on you. How's the military look? Could look better. I got a lot of defenders. 21 cannons, though, if I burn, like, through 6 per city. I'll just have to build some more. Not impossible. Wonder if I can get that done in one turn. That's plus 1 trade rail per city. That'll pay for itself.
Corporation. Noun. An ingenious device for obtaining individual profit without individual responsibility.
All right. Can't whip that, huh? Oh, well. Guess you're just going to starve to death. Guess we're gonna do this. Fuck. Guess we're gonna fucking do this. I just can't let the AIs... I mean, I have such a powerful, like, military advantage right here. I need to do something with this. So, that's what we're gonna do. Something. I'm not in a position to hit multiple cities like I would have liked, but I guess we'll see where this goes. Now, one possible strategy would be to declare war and let the enemy AI come to me with its military and then kill it. Am I going to use corporation? Oh, I mean, I research corporation. Am I going to use corporations? I don't know. Kind of depends where this game goes. I'm not going to beeline anything specific. I'm behind so many technologies that I kind of want to resolve that, you know? I also have to keep in mind that Mansa Musa is trying to win this game. And so, after whatever war I fight over here, I need to quickly shift gears and go kill Mansa Musa. He's cut his research, and he's been cut on that for some time. Just, sitting in his places. He doesn't have that much military. I say that, but, you know, he's not that far behind me. An alternative would be for me to allow my cities to recover more as I get, like, more railroads set up, but I don't want to wait. Okay. 26 cities, and yet I still feel pressured to keep doing this. Well, I mean, the war with Bacall went better than what I thought it would. That's a fact. What time is it? Do I want to start another exhausting war right now? That will keep the game going, I guess. Gets my better judgment. Let's do this. What could go wrong? Well, I'm under no threat of, like, having so many of my cities eaten that I just collapse in on myself. That's not possible. Like, my worry here is that this war takes me so long, and I burn through so many resources for no real gain, I'm just stunted. And even if I can fly over here and kill Mansa Musa, I end up so far behind, Babylon, it's an uphill climb for me, you know. Infantry would not be bad, neither would factories. I should probably just try to pursue that. I don't know, I'm in a fucking war, man. Now that I'm in war, let's go ahead and swap off this. Still don't have the ironworks build. Maybe I'll build that at some point. I'll just think about building it, you know? Hey, still making gold per turn. Neat. That's probably because I took the immense focus off of food and production. Still getting nice production, though. Good. Let's go. Yep, welcome to the war. I'll take one war elephant along with me. Let's go. Now, we might just start losing cities left and right. Like, we have a vast border, and I don't have a whole lot of defenses scattered around these places. And so it is entirely feasible that just suddenly everything collapses out from under me. And that would be a damn shame. I'm now committed to this. This is where we live right now. This is our place. So, let me go ahead and check to see whether there's any military milled about. Not yet. He'll have to organize something, though. He wasn't plotting war, of course. And I have to keep in mind that this city does exist, Cimmerian, or whatever the fuck. He might try something from that angle. Let's get this done. Maybe. Or die in the process. That wasn't a good sign. I didn't like seeing that. Fucking airships. Oh, God. It's like that old game I just talked about all over again. Oh, of course he's bombarding me. Oh, man. It's only airships. Only a few airships. Oh, no. Okay, it was only a machine gun. Okay, that's gonna suck. We can beat through that, we just need more cannons. A Mayan revolt has taken place? Really? Ah, this fucking trash city. Christ, I might just give it back. I don't have time for this right now. You are rude. I was hoping to... fucking war elephant didn't do a damn thing. Shit. Okay. At least that worked. We'll keep this going. We might end up pausing this session in the middle of this war. So you have that to look forward to, I guess. We demand emancipation! Brr! I'm like, okay. Brr! Well, I'll give you more to be unhappy about, I guess. Alright, where am I going to organize my next attack from? If I'm going to try to attack from a different angle with, like, cannons I'll store up. Here, here. Probably Seoul. Probably. I don't like my unit skirting too close to the edge like that. Hopefully we don't get our asses raffle stomped. It could happen. Although I did say that it was actually my fight with Pakal that would end up being who controls this game, I can still very much lose this game. This game is most assuredly losable. Let's go ahead. I already just saved, though. I'm sure it'll be fine. He says, sobbing profusely later. Alright, let's actually go ahead and... Dog, why do you vex me? Indy. Indy, there's nothing that interesting outside. Indy, I promise. Indy, I'm fighting a war here. Okay, how bad is it? Andy. Two grenadiers there in the fort. We've got that stack there. Oh, shit. That's bad. That is something that we would consider on some measure of level of bad. What are you talking about, Grimith? This is fine. We're fine. No, I'm not worried. No, I'm not scared. I'm not owned. You're owned. It's a lot of cavalry. It's, feel like I've been here before, only on the other side of this. Here's the thing, though. Consider this. He takes Seoul. What the fuck did that city really matter to me, right? It's not that big of a deal in the grand scheme of things. I take one of his very powerful cities that sharply cuts down at his production base. Seoul wasn't really doing a whole lot for me. But, right there, that was doing a lot for Suri of Armin. Naturally, we're going to have to spend time recovering and licking our wounds because, ow. But we're no longer being strangled here, culturally. Which was the whole purpose of that exercise. Now, if... You know, it's not impossible, actually. Those cavalry, could just go lo 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 lo, and I'd lose the city. With that in mind, let's get a rifle so that's a little bit harder for that to transpire. But they actually have cannons in the stack, and because there's cannons in the stack, the cavalry will want to, like, take care. That being said, they could easily just road, railroad, lo 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 lo. That's the exact sound effect that makes, by the way. Lo 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 lo. Alright, I weakened some of their units a little bit. I don't know if that's going to make a difference in the grand scheme of things, but damn it, I tried. Wish I'd had these railroads sooner, man. Mm-mm-mm. Gotta get that stack. Stack. Stack, 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 stack. What the shit is this? Are you having a giggle, mate? He's like, aha! And I'm like, what? He's like, aha? I'm like, this guy. Of course I fucking lost it. Of course that died too. Oh my god. Ha ha! There. Ha? I could easily lose this city. Yeah, it's a thought, huh? I could lose that city. I don't want to lose that city. I'm kind of attached to that city. It meant something to me, damn it. Of course. Why didn't I think of that? I'm actually gonna keep this cannon here, because there might be a cavalry unit that swings around and mean. I don't think there will be. Based on, like, the vision I have, and there's no railroads there? Okay, maybe not. But know that I thought about it. Yeah, boy. Okay. So much micro. Oh yeah, you! I remember you. Oh no, right? The deals got canceled. Hey, you wanna open No! Wait, no, we're fine. Oh, we have to fucking declare war to move this missionary in. Oh, my plans! Perhaps you'll like me again one day. Oh, that's right, effing. What an astute observation by an astute man. How bad is it? How bad was that? Oh, you know. Didn't, a 1-1 fight? A 1-1 battle? Yep. Totally just won a battle. That's pretty good. Just let him go ahead and get promoted over there. Yep. Mm-hmm. He deserves those promotions. He's certainly done more enough to earn those promotions. It's fine. I wish I had a Medic 3 Great General hanging around here. Kind of squandered some of my Great Generals. Certainly could have attached one to an Explorer, though, and I'd heal much quicker. That'd be nice. Certainly would be nice. Alright, we got a Medic 1. We got Medic 1 guys here. Should probably have told them to, like, try and get more collateral damage. Well, it's too late now. How long is it gonna take to heal you guys? Answer that question's too fucking long. Everyone, you heal up, take a few turns, sob into a pillow. Okay. Well, the good news is that we have a lot of cannons heading towards the city. The bad news is that there's a lot of cavalry knocking on the door saying, hello! And I'm like, ah, no. Like, yeah, so you remember me? And I'm like, no. Alright, we caused collateral damage. Alright, good. We actually got a retreat in there. What a novel concept. If I just keep weakening them, maybe it'll go away. I got a draft here again. There are cities that are already unhappy with me, but damn it. It's gotta be done. What an exciting time. These are interesting times and moments and all kinds of other nonsensical shit. Should probably get another rifle even there. Military. Send a military. Alright, those will heal in a few turns. Where do I go with them next? Do I go straight after his capital? I'm much stronger than he is, actually. I actually got military intel on him now. 1.7 strength. That's good. Good. He, of course, refuses to talk. I want to punch some technology out of him. Again, I don't care about killing him. I just want to punch a bunch of tech out of him. That's all. You know? And maybe take his capital, too. We'll see. Right, Wall Street. We don't have enough banks kicking around for me to build Wall Street, but banks would certainly help the income, considering how low our research slider is. It's hard to spare all these things right now. We're kind of busy, folks, believe it or not. Alright, that was disheartening, but we didn't lose a city. That was close. Well, that's going down the next turn. Yeah, he definitely did attack this city, though. Wow. So close to losing the city. Just go ahead and start bombarding his units right there. Pew pew! So close to losing this damn city, man. Damn, that was close. That city is so angry now that it's gonna fucking start revolting on me. But let me kill those cavalry while they're super weakened. Alright, we weathered that storm. I mean, this city's gonna be useless for a while, but we weathered that storm. Good. Let's go ahead and kill those units while they're still- I'm fucking so damn chuffed that we damn survived that only just. Comes to be that the soothing light at the end of your tunnel is just a freight train coming your way, AI. Speaking of AI, seen some railroads scattered around here. We'll get that assembly line technology, oh, you know, somewhere this side of forever. No bad to our health here. It's not bad, not bad. I like those grenadiers. I like having a few grenadiers in the stack. Do I go after the capital? Shit. I gotta leave a good enough defense force. It's gonna take me so many turns, though. 1, 2, 3, 4. Eh, and I'll be attacking across a river. New! A river! I don't wanna attack across a river. Fuck me. Okay, I hate attacking cross rivers. Guess I fucking made up my mind. Oh, man. I don't want to do amphibious. Let's go ahead and leave 5 defenders here. There's so much population in that city. Let's go. It's going to take a while, and we're going to drive right past these guys, and they're going to go, and I'm going to be sad. I don't want to be sad. Alright, we'll leave 4 defenders. Oh boy. Okay. JDL. No, Luca, no! Luca, please stop! Damn it, Luca! Nice things! Let's go ahead and draft there. Where else do we want to draft? If I were to draft... gonna be right here. Hell no, we won't go. The fuck you won't go. You fucking gunk. This war is important, man. Just like all the other wars that will come after it. They're important. Man. We're kind of shredded here. We can't... All we can do is just cry. Just cry a little into the pillow. It'll be okay. Fucking airships, man. He's got one survivor there, though. We didn't get them all. We just got some of them. No, my water hole! You monster! You fucking son of a bitch! That was my water hole! How could you? One of my stupid AI workers is like, no. Of course, that's the guy with one strength who poaches a worker, right? Didn't even lose any strength on that guy. Good. My water hole. Now folks are kind of talking about strategy while playing Sid Meier's Alpha Centauri, which is not quite this game. It's a good game. I still have the tech tree up behind my computer. But it's not this game. I'm actually fucking chuffed that I damn survived that attack. Alright, let's go ahead and, I don't know, cut his empire off, I guess. We'll attack with Wonsan over here, and then we'll be unified, and we'll start driving towards the capital. How much time do I have? Okay. Unless he starts, like, culture bombing me or some shit, I got bags of time. Wait. Okay. I need to reconfigure. Not reconfigure, you just need to think a bit more. Yeah, he's running free speech. Okay. He just... All right. I'm fine. Carry on. Carry on. Nothing bad happened. Hopefully, folks, this demonstrates to you the power of cannons. I've said this before in so many videos, and I've never really had to demonstrate it a whole lot, but with cannons, you can. And, I have. War elephants into cannon. I'm gonna enjoy living in that city in 10 turns. It's gonna be good. It's gonna be so delish. And nutrish. And maybe, just maybe, burnt to a crisp. Okay. Where? Where? Anyone actually producing wealth? There are a few places that are. They need to stop that shit. We need more rifles, more cannons, because nuts of technology. We'll just punch it out of people. Again, this whole conquering process would be so sped up if I actually had vassal states on, but I hate the mechanics so much. Absolutely despise it. You urge me to adopt bureaucracy, huh? I can't switch off a nationhood, man. That plus two happy from barracks is crucial. You must learn to respect our differences, Mansa Musa. No. You see me as your worst enemy. Why would I give you a thing? Tell you what. How about you give me that 20 golden tribute? That's what I thought. Hey, you want me to not kill you? 90 gold. Thank you. That's what I thought. It's so nice to actually demand tribute from the AI, too. Two rifles is probably good enough. Let's go. Let's go. My body is ready. Is your body ready? Hope it is. Darkness has fallen upon the land and in my room. just lit by the lovely seductive glow of Civilization 4. There stands Machine Gunner, two rifles behind him, versus the combined wrath of Brennus and his war elephants. There's a war elephant. It's an honorary thing at this point. It's honorary, okay? That elephant means something, damn it. It means get fucked. Oh, no. No. Things happen. No. Oh. Oh. Sorry, I saw that text solo there from Ansa Moose, and I thought he actually picked up his research lighter. No, he's just been on democracy forever. Sorry. The brain gets a bit rusty sometimes, you know? You know. I'm also hoping to him in those airships so that they don't have anywhere to retreat to. That'd be nice. Super swell. So much nicer to travel across my empire with railroads. Don't know whether we'll attack face first into this city. Two cavalry, two rifles, two cannons versus... Fuck it, I guess we will. This city, though, for sure. Okay, I think that's good enough collateral damage. Let's just select the rifles here. And spare the rest of my cannons. Take that. Thank you. Thank you for your patronage. Another delicious holy city, and we got a Scotland Yard here. Neat. We're doing good. We're doing good. I like it. Everything has finally come together for me in this game. Man, I'm so pleased now. Handled that war with Pakal so nicely. Yeah. We're still not out of the danger zone yet. Yeah, I'm sure this stack will be fine. Okay. So, that city's been taken. We're gonna take this next turn. That'll put us in a pretty strong position to start pushing in for the capital. And we'll consign Surrey of Arma to some shit somewhere, I'm sure. He's furious. He wants to know what the hell I want. He's willing to give me theology. Oh, that's a very compelling argument. I must say, theology. Oh, ho, ho. Slow down, be still my heart. Oh, shit. Whoa. Don't think I can handle that kind of awesomeness there. Oof. Probably should have left more than one defender. I thought I moved more people in that city. Well, goddammit, that's awkward. No. Ah. Ah, he didn't take it back. Ah. Ah. Alright, sure. Could have sworn he would have taken that city back. Alright, yeah. Yeah, okay. I lost another... Come on, man. Why are you trolling with these cannons? Why are you always lying? Why are you always lying? Why are you always lying? Stop the fucking lying. Kick some ass. Seems like he got more defenders in here all of a sudden, huh? That's tragic. That's okay. Let's go ahead and get rid of those airships. Get to keep those lovely espionage buildings. Airships, bombard. Enemy units. It's a free way to get damage. And, you know, if you don't stop the heal, that can kind of, like, stack up on units. you know, and hurt them. They're not as effective as, you know, say, bombers. But it starts that early phase. I guess I can go ahead and show off the airship here. It can see submarines as well. And inflict significant damage to naval units. Of course, this is not really a naval map. Shit happens. Okay. What do we want to do now? These two most certainly need to defend that site. Which site? That site. You think that's quicker? I don't think that's a smart idea, Chief. I think you should stick to this, boss. Just got through that out there. I mean, yeah, I kind of know I'm a rebel and all, but you know, kind of fucking, you know. I know words, right? You fucking, I mean, come on, man. It's kind of ridiculous if you fucking think you're gonna do that, man. Yeah, this war's turned out pretty well. Grimith is pleased. The gods are pleased with your sacrifice. Okay. Go ahead and actually slide you two in there, because you folks need to heal. Y'all need to heal now. That'll probably be good. He's going to be standing there, and he'll probably move, since his Guerrilla 2 fort no longer really controls much of anything on the board. I expect him to, anyway. What do I want to do with you guys? Versus a cav and a bunch of cannons. That sounds like a collateral headache. Ugh. Duh, fuck. Alright. I don't want that to hit me. I don't want that to hit me. No. I can't reach to kill them, though. Arrgh, I don't have a two-movement unit. Arrgh, fuck. That's gonna suck. All right. We have to keep moving on the capital. But that sucks. We're all kind of like divided up now. How about we do this? You guys just pick raw combat too. We'll kind of see what happens. Yeah, that's about what I expected. You go ahead and build a jail. You're going to jail. Rifle, cannon. So, do tell me what happens. By the way, my population is exceeding the domination limit. I would just need the required requisite territory, which I am short on by 29%. I'm gonna need a lot more land. Yeah, anyway, as I expected, that hurt. That definitely hurt. I'm not stopping, though. I have a city to take here, man. Oh no, another Maya revolt. That probably means I'm gonna lose this city. Maya, adequate. Don't you tell me to get on with it. If I offer to liberate, what is this trash city? 8.53% high. Yeah, I'm pretty sure I'm gonna lose this. What would this be worth to you? Maybe I can offer it to someone else. Would anyone else be interested in the city? I doubt it. I just have to fucking kill him later. I think I can just give it back to him. Hey, Mayans, remember when I took this city from you? It wasn't really worth it, was it? We all make mistakes. What is it called? Quirigua? Quirigua? Sure allowed me to free up those units. Hey. Don't say I never gave you anything. There. Plus one. I've liberated his city. Good guy, Grimith. Such a benevolent god. I have bestowed an infinite kindness upon him that, Well, it was probably going to flip back to him anyway. I'm not going to station a bunch of military units up there. Although, the fact that all this culture is now in my face because of that is a thing. But hey, you know, you gotta take the good with the bad. As a great philosopher once said, you take the good, you take the bad, you take them both, and then you have the facts of life. That's how that goes. Can we make it there? No. Can you make it there? No. Disappointed. You can. So he's pretty poorly defended now, of course. All of you folks, pick a barrage too. Y'all should probably go ahead and heal up now. You hear? You heard? Looks like he's moved off of guerrilla defense, which means I'll go ahead and kill him. Good. He's in a better place now. Trust me. Okay. If I were gonna possibly even entertain the idea that you might revolt, which I wouldn't, but if I were, where would I go? Okay. My turn. Actually got pretty poor odds against him. That's not good. Damn. Alright. Well, we've been stymied on that front. Ah, he's got a good stack of cav and rifles to defend that city. Nice defense, too. That's on a hill. I don't want to attack that across a river, which means I gotta want to move there and then move there. That's gonna be slow. Time to get fucked. Alright. Looking fine. I guess I could have drafted more, huh? We have plenty of happiness in our cities. We have plenty of unhappiness in our cities. You know? It is a thing. I feel pretty good, though. I feel pretty good. I did have some worries and doubts and reservations about, you know, I just didn't want to fucking lose this shit to Pakal, right? Like, I fought Pakal there for, like, control of the game. He downed me. I was a turn away from rifles. It was, I thought it would be touch and go. But thankfully, I managed to pull that together. Pakal badly misused his stack. You know, it being all the way down here instead of doing something more relevant, I don't fucking understand why his stack was so far away from any meaningful interaction. He declared war on me. Like, I only lost Carib there towards the end, and I immediately countered by taking Sol. Not towards the end, you know, but like, I did lose it, but I held on to it for much longer, and I thought Horatio Nelson did a great job. I will never forget his meaningful contribution to the team. Make no mistake. He is a hero, and I will remember it as such until he's no longer remembered as such. Okay, looks like our friends have retreated a bit here. Probably to go heal. Yeah, that's where he's moved. He's moved to heal those units. Meanwhile, here I am. On the road again. Okay. I don't know whether that city will even be there in 3 turns. I might bombard it down. It's got a lot of cultural defense. I might actually bombard that one. I kind of do want to end this war soonish. Courtesy of, you know, Mansa Musa. He's there going like, hey, I'm Mansa Musa. What's up, buddy? I'm trying to win the game through a cultural victory, okay? You don't mind that? You don't have a problem with that, do you, buddy? And I'm like, yes? He's like, oh, okay. I'm like, God damn it. God damn you, Matsumusa. Curse you for everything. He's like, oh, man, why you gotta curse me? I'm a good guy. I eat my vegetables. Like, I don't give a damn about you eating your vegetables. But you have a nice cover. Shut the fuck up.
I'm not gonna run another golden age.
With this next great person I get. It's gonna be sweet.
Damn, it takes a while to move this military.
Maybe I shouldn't have given away that city for free. Maybe I should have just made it, you know, fucking revolt back to him. Cannon on cannon action. Yep, that's happening. Go ahead and kill that. Move next to the city. I don't think he's going to be attacking out. God, I have to move. I can't just not move. That's too painful. Alright, let's go ahead and move. And I'll start bombarding next turn. I keep referring my units to that tile that has an oasis and no actual railroad for when I inevitably take this damn city. Oh well. So, waypoints, huh? Those would be pretty swell, right? Waypoints do exist in this game, I think, actually. Ah. I use them so rarely. Doesn't matter. I'm gonna win this war. I don't know whether I'll win. I guess I'll just keep this broadcast going until I win this war, and then we'll have to look ahead to Matsumusa and friends, because we've kicked the shit out of our enemies. We've done a pretty good job. Korea's down to one city. That in part was due to Pakal, but I took a few. Mongolia's dead. Suryavarman's going to be down to only a few cities. Leaving only Matsumusa and Babylon on the map. This has been a slow snowball, but I'm glad to see that I held this together so well. I think all that extra planning and preparation I did for the Pakal War paid off. No regrets about doing that. Okay. Yep, that's fine. So we just move all of our units into manners of crazy positions. That's right, slowly but surely the advance of Grimith. This isn't the most exciting game to watch right now either. I know. It's like, the game feels like it's decided, but I haven't won yet. I could end up making a miscalculation that does cost me this game. Matsumusa is chugging along here. And I do plan on fighting Babylon. I think I'm going to need some of his land in order for me to win the game domination-wise. But hey, what a novel concept for me not to win a game with cavalry, right? Or cuirassiers. Although we probably won't end up seeing the modern stuff. Though, I mean, machine guns is probably as modern, or airships is as modern as we're getting. It depends on what Babylon's got when we actually declare war on him. He's got assembly line, so he's got infantry, so that sucks. We'll just need a lot more cannons. We'll need a lot more cannons. We have 28 cities. We can manage more cannons. Also, we are bleeding money. Okay, I think... Rifle, cancel that, build wealth. All these cannons, build another cannon, than produce wealth. I guess I should, probably should have fixed this a little bit better, but oh well. Rifle. Wealth. You're already doing wealth. That can't be good. Whatever. You're fine. And you, cannon. Wealth. Some of you don't have any experience points on your units, though. I think it's because some of my buildings have just been sabotaged, and I've not actually damn fixed them. It happens, you know? I get in the zone like this place. Doesn't even have a fucking granary even more. I just haven't rebuilt it. It's hard to keep track of all those details, you know? Like, effort, man. Who has time for effort? Certainly not this guy right here. This guy. You know this guy. This is the guy. Pay you no mind to the screams of children. As my citizenry runs in terror from me. Alright. We're gonna start stacking up in my capital now. I think I got enough military to take down Surrey of Armin. 84 riflemen, yeah. Yeah, I got a few. I got a few. I'm gonna have to start being more sparing with my cannons. I talk about that on occasion, and then I'm actually not more sparing with my cannons. Some might consider that a flaw. Oh yes, I'm so puny. Ah. So puny when it comes to being advanced. Ugh. It's disgusting. I'll never manage to accomplish anything in this game at this rate. Oh no. No, I'm doomed. I should probably end up sending more cannons to the warfront, though. I don't know. Kind of want to start building up stack of some kind with these units. I mean, I do still have plenty of time before Mansa Musa really threatens to win, but what the hell, right? How's the strength of these units? I'm probably just got to burn through all these cannons here to take his capital. Man, that hurt. Tagging across the river with those cannons. We still have some losing odds in there. There we go. That opened it up. Sargon, the great general? Well, that great general was so great, why did he just die? Asking for a friend. I have the great lighthouse. It's a shame it's damn obsoleted now. Guess it ain't that fucking great. I moved a war elephant. I don't think I should have moved. All my cities got a defender in them? Still? That was accidental. Oh, there we go. That's where you were. Grimith made a mistake. It could happen to anybody. Yeah. Damn. It's not quite good enough. Oh, yes, I have the Colossus, too. No, not here. I might have it somewhere, though. Hold on. Let me take a look. Colossus? Yep, I do. It obsoletes with astronomy, which I haven't researched yet. I don't think I have. Have I? No, I definitely have. It's obsoleted. Good news, everyone. It's fucked. Everything is fucked. Alright. I don't care about the defensive terrain. Let's just go ahead and roll in, guys. Oh, all these guys are fully healed now. Great. Let's go. I know, so much delicious gold income now. It's beautiful. In part because some of my, my lands are producing wealth again. Ah, great profit is what we got. Well, I'm gonna enjoy this golden age. Good. Not bad. Not bad. It turns out with 29 cities, you can do some damage to research, even if they're not great cities. And the improvements are pretty trash. You can do some damage. Good. I wonder if I should sell steel to Bacall. Maybe I'll consider that. Build a bank for me, actually. That'd be cool, if you build a bank. That way I can get myself a Wall Street somewhere. That'd be pretty neat. I'll bombard this city down because I don't have all of my units in position that I'd love to have in position. Interesting. He has suicided some workers into me. Fascinating. Tell me more. I'll take your workers. I'll take them to the bank. Give some of my units a march. There we go. I miss my cannons. Let me go ahead and save the game in case, you know, there's another power outage, or it crashes, or I'm sabotaged for whatever reason. This was a nice return to Civilization 4. We had some fun, we had some giggles. I'm glad I did it. I had that idea, you know, the desire, after playing Civilization 6, to play Civilization 4. And so there we were, playing Civilization 4. Don't make the same damn mistake of this guy again. I mean, could've gone worse. Could've gone worse. Could've gone better. Could've gone worse. I'm glad I did it. Of course, I'm in this good mood right now because I feel as if I'm gonna win this one. But I'm not gonna let myself get too sloppy. That's definitely some shit I've done before in video games. And I've ended up regretting it. I love these old interior cities that just have one warrior defending them. I know, best endorsement is Civ 6. Boy, that game. I don't think this is disappointing as Civ 5 when it came out, but then again, I played Civ 6 on a friend's account. I didn't actually buy it myself, whereas I bought Civ 5 shortly after release. God, that game. That game. It's certainly a game. Yep. It's great. It's great. It's great. Love it. Tremendous. So, I think I'll leave Surrey of Armin with these two cities and mop up these three. I think that's good. Running short on cannons. But that's okay. What is this? Oh, it's a cavalry. I didn't even know that was there. Well, didn't see it in all the hubbub. Civilization 4, of course, you know, had like a few issues on release. I got this shortly after release as well, but they weren't as bad. In my opinion, the game was better balanced. In part because it was building off of concepts of old. Like Civilization 2 is a direct upgrade to Civ 1, and Civ 4 is a direct upgrade to Civilization 3. Like, you go play Civ 3 and you just get mired in all the corruption and some of the other mechanics of the game, like no production overflow, for instance. Whereas that exists. Civilization 5 branches out into its entirely new path. Of course, John Schaefer was the lead design there, and he was heavily inspired by Panzer General, which is why you have the one unit per tile mechanic, which fundamentally changes the entire balance and playstyle of the game, because Like, with one unit per tile, you need to have fewer units on the board, so you end up having to adjust tile yields. You know, building yields have to end up being adjusted as well. Consequently, like, early Civilization V ends up in a massive carpet of doom from just about any AI in high difficulty. It's absolutely ugly to just see, like, every hex and, like, fucking, like a 70, like, 70 hexes around, like, all the cities just filled with units. And it's like, Jesus, I can kill these, but they'll take forever. Yes, Civilization IV also had very strong, like, balancing and, like, contributions from the community, and very solid multiplayer. After Civilization IV is when the series starts to get away from, like, multiplayer. Like, Civilization V didn't focus on multiplayer at all. It was an afterthought, and that shows. That showed in the very beginning with numerous bugs that I found while playing the game with multiplayer, and it also shows that the AI is a bit more derpy and not as effective in multiplayer in Civ 5, because they're geared more towards, like, a single-player interaction. Civ 6 has its own, like, I could not fully, like, expound upon what I feel is an educated opinion of Civilization 6, whereas Civ 5 I've covered in numerous videos of mine while playing Civilization 4 and Civilization 5, because I've done that before on my channel as well. Well, Wolfar, I can understand a dislike for the Stack of Doom, but what you end up with in Civilization V is the AI's inability to effectively order their units around. Because, unlike, say, in a Panzer General, your Civilization V maps are much smaller, they're much more crowded. You know, you're looking at these vast, like, mountain ranges or whatever, gulfs, and the AI is trying to shift all of their various units around in order to effectively and cohesively attack targets. They've gotten better at it at Civ 5 Final versus Civ 5 1.0, but just with a few composite bowmen, you can easily repel any sort of early attack that the AI might try to throw at you. You might panic and see a shit ton of units, but you can easily repel that sort of thing. As a result, I think the earlier civilizations work better for the AI, because they're not trying to... Like, if it was an AI built for tactical warfare, that's one thing. But this AI is covering so many other different things. I also feel as if civilization is, while war is an inherent component of it, I just don't see it as a tactical war game. You know, it's a strategy sweeping in scope. Civilization 6 again is a whole different fucking can of worms, and I don't want to get into that right now, other than I'm not buying that one. Not for a long time. Long time. Man, I don't even care what you guys produce. I just fell to fucking jail, I guess. I love how I'm like, I don't even just build this. It's for the best. You're in a better place now. Okay, let's throw a few cannons into this. Hopefully three is good enough, because I don't want to sacrifice anymore. We'll give you City of Raider. Is that good enough? What are we looking at there for odds if I attacked? That fucking machine gun, man. That hurt. We got it. We had it. Another Scotland Yard. Delicious. We save some of the cannons. Save the cannons! We had some warm bodies to throw at the situation, and so we did. Hey, if art style is really a turn off for you, I mean, I don't think that's petty, it just, it's a matter of what you enjoy looking at. It's like, some folks, like, dislike certain art styles so much that they just can't play and enjoy the game. Like, that's just who you are. I don't think there's anything petty about that. If that's your fucking deal breaker, it's your fucking deal breaker. Only you can really determine what games are best and most enjoyable for you. Alright, how do I divide this shit up? I got so many units scattered around here. I'm like, blerg. Effort. I hate applying myself. Still have this stack of fun. And profit and games. We'll have to invest this somewhere. I guess I'll get anger what first? Anger what? Yeah. Anger what? We'll take this city. We'll take Angerthom. We'll peace out. We'll end the broadcast. And then I guess we're playing Civilization 4 next Thursday. As I hopefully am able to finish up this game. We do still have a time crunch there. Have it. Where? Oh. Oh, he cut his culture. He's back to researching. Where? Okay. Yeah, okay. He's trying to lull me into a false sense of security. I see. Your clever ploys won't fucking work on me, asshat. I know your tricks. Oh, shit. That was good. What the hell? I'll be the one who takes a worker. Nuts to it. Fucking bizarre. Oh yeah, this city. Yeah, I need to whip this. Completely forgot about you up here. I'm so sorry. Here you go. Let's burn 5 population right there in the damn synagogue. And then, let's burn another 3 population on the aqueduct. There, you're all in a better place now. You're welcome. I'm sorry, I neglected giving you all the whip. My bad. I was so excited to whip you all, too. And I'm like, oh man, damn. Shit. Alright. You folks can just go sit here for a while. That's fine with me. Well, you can strategic genius your way out of a... Like, there's a difference between, like, strategy and tactics, and in the particular case of, like, say you're facing that stack of doom, there are ways for you to resolve a stack of doom. From collateral damage, to... Collateral damage. To collateral damage. If someone marches a stack of doom right in front of your face, you collateral damage them, then you pick off weaklings, or you let them crash into your defenses. Now, Civ 4 multiplayer, like competitive, works far differently compared to that, because you have a lot of like guerrilla warfare tactics, and it's not so much like a stack of doom as it is like proper unit positioning, which in a way is tactics as well. Say, for example, like if you get to a human player early, and if you can control their metal or their horses, you can starve them out, you can wall them in, and win the game that way. It's not impossible to do that against the AI, but they have map hack. They see where your units are. That doesn't mean that you can't still, like poach off their workers. Like, say, if you have a warrior with Woodsman 2, because they can't take that into account. But in that way, like fighting humans is so much different compared to fighting AI in Civilization 4. Anyway, that's enough chattering on about that. I guess I can go grab another. Yeah, there are a number of modifications. Fall from Heaven 2, of course. Oh gosh, there's a one that Manikai and Jonas have loved to play with each other so much that I can't recall the name of. There's Romance of the Three Kingdoms. I played that for some time, not recorded. There's Caveman to Cosmos, of course. Not doing too bad here, though. Not doing too bad. Really, I'm just, again, I'm pleased that, with Bacall went as well as it did. I was worried, seeing his military strength. I was a little worried that, I was going to lose, well, more than I did. I only lost one city, And that was significantly into the war. I took that city back, of course. What the hell? Nah, I'm not gonna bother with it. Not worth my time to fight that fight. Just a delaying tactic. Okay. We'll go ahead and build a theater there. Barracks for the +2 happiness. I'm trying to pay enough attention to micro these things a little bit. It's not that easy to do. Finally, now that we got 30 cities, we're seeing some good numbers here. Finally. Oops. Pressed the wrong button. It's also helping that our workers are able to rapidly build better tile improvements now, because we have steam power. Well, Wolfar. And part is just a matter of who you play against, right? And people approach strategy games in different ways. Like, the most wonderful of strategy games forces you to, like, constantly adapt to your environs instead of just having a quick, easy, like, access to an I win button. It forces you to understand the situation. You can't just pull out the same exact strategy on it for it to work every time. That's a quality strategy game experience. Still love seeing that dead there. Makes me feel good that I did a good. Let's go ahead and knock this theater up here so I can whip out the population. There we go. We've stagnated it all. Good. They finally agree with me. A nice amount of bank now, too. It's all the cities we've been raiding. No, I don't feel like stopping the war against me. I'm pretty good with thanks. Appreciate the offer, though. It's a pretty cool offer. Probably should have taken collateral damage more so. It does help to diversify your cannon assortment a little bit to have, like, folks who crack open cities versus folks who focus solely on collateral damage. But I admit I'm being a little lazy. Also, I keep misplacing my cannons. They keep going to heaven. My bad. You know, along with, like, having some folks who have different promotions, like multiple drills. Some folks who have multiple combats are like the pinch for the extra bonus versus gunpowder units. It's just a matter of like me being, we probably got this. I won those battles in some pretty low odds there. I'm okay with that. We'll be taking this city. I expect Babylon's culture to oppress this pretty damn soon. And shift 2 defenders in here, and then everyone else start working towards Angerthom. We'll be there in a few turns. Let's see here. We still have a few cities that are building those. Suppose I should probably stop them from doing that. Shift those there. You take care of that. We'll all be there. Good. Yeah, Wolfar, I certainly do remember that in Caveman to Cosmos. It was an experience for sure. Okay. Sorry about that mild interruption. Again, the fates and the cosmos are trying to do everything they can in their power to prevent me from enjoying my life. Alright, that's three defenders left behind. That will probably be good enough to defend this city. There's a settler in there. The fucking course. No, well, no, my problem. Got a nice amount of cannons here. We'll definitely want more, though, before we go to war. Although, the pressure to fight Mansa Musa is not as large as it used to be now, since he's finally decided, you know what, shit, I better start researching again. So there's that. That's a thing. Alright, everyone. We need factories. I'm sure what you were doing was all immensely important. But, no, we need factories. You all build me a factory. And then you three, once you're done with the military unit, build me a factory. Do you have physics, Suryavarman? You do. Well, what don't you have? You don't have fascism. I guess I could go after fascism. Research that. Because I do plan on punching a few tanks out of him. Getting a nice amount of beakers now. I said that before, though. Let's go. You three. We can now start building infantry. Amount of promotions there. Maybe I should leave more of these units around. Because I might try attacking him from this side. How close are we to the domination victory? Oh, we still have plenty of land area we need to grab still. Shit. Alright. So be it. I'll probably grab that democracy sooner rather than later. Alright, I lost some workers. Where did I lose those? That's what I get for not paying attention more to, like, enemy unit positioning here. Because he just dirt me and killed my workers. Those were pretty workers, man. Why you gotta do that, Grimith? Alright, it's time for this crossbow to suddenly get upgraded to an infantry. Don't really appreciate or approve of that, man. It's, that's rather disturbing. The nerve. The audacity. Just strolling into my territory, taking my workers that I took from you fair and square. Yep, that's exactly the right move, man. That's the move. Fuck. Alright. How bad is that gonna be? Alright, that's not awful. Why don't you just go ahead and stay there for now? I don't think I'm gonna need those extra reinforcements to take Angerthom and then win this war. Question is, do I feel like bothering with these guys? Well, I might. Alright, Mace Man, time for you to put down your mace. Grab a gun. My crossbowman that was actually an infantry killed a cavalry. Woo! Alright. So a little frustrating, but we took care of that. I know, you fucking casual. I'm glad in a few years that we were able to train them to be more than effective with that weaponry. Absolutely. Oh. You're revolting. That's a thing. Stop revolting. Here, sacrifice those five people to heaven. And we'll be fine. You get a synagogue, and you get a synagogue. Everyone gets a synagogue. Except for the people who don't get synagogues. Okay. That fucking machine gun man. Trying to knock him off his perch there. Alright.
We'll be keeping this.
Ah, the Great Library, Parthenon, Broadway, Military Academy, Temple of Artemis. Broadway, huh? Alright, sure. I like it. Put it in the bag. Okay. Friend. Not you. Wrong friend. Friend. What is this shit? Brr. I'm not giving you anything. Brr. Are you kidding me right now? That's all I want. Just that. No? Okay. Have it your way. Something, something Burger King. Sorry, Varmint. The war didn't have to come to this, man. We could have just ended this. I could have let you live out the rest of your days there in a little retirement home, man. Why you gotta do this, man? For fuck's sakes. Okay. He still has one good city. You're right. Yeah, that does exist, huh? You know what I should have done with this deck? Taking care of that. Let's go, everyone. Fucking had enough of this shit. I was building that stack over there. I should have made use out of that sooner, huh? Oh well. It's being done now. I don't have time for your shit, man. Once I take this city, and then he's left with these two, maybe he'll start negotiating more. I mean, look at these rubbish cities, man. So smothered in ice. What the hell do I know, right? Ah. Mansa Musa's going after assembly line. Wise choice. Wise choice. I can't fault him for that. Okay, I might have to research a little bit more now. Biology would definitely make my city stronger, so I'm going to go ahead and grab biology. I'm coming for you. I'm gonna hug you. It's gonna be great. Hug, 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 hug. Alright. When it's time to party, we will party hard for the fight. So, what's the revolt chance like here now? Good. Good. All is well in the world. This city. I mean, I guess you really don't have anything. Oh well. Such is life. How's that war weariness? You know, it's not that bad. Thanks to police state. Sorry, Varmin, just give me your technology. It's for the best. It's for your own good. Don't you want this war to be over? Just concede. I think he just ran some cannons into me here. Just let it go. Let it go. Let it go. Don't you want to let it go? This fight doesn't have to be yours any longer. It can be someone else's fight. I promise. It doesn't have to be like this. Ugh. Ugh. Alright, maybe it has to be like this. Oh, piss. Okay, fine. Man, we've eaten quite a few cities. I'll miss you cannons that I was gonna use for another fight. Okay, I got another one of these, huh? That's fine. It's fine. Fucking fine. Think I have a military academy here already? I do. Let me sift through the old cities here. Don't have a military academy there. Didn't think so. It's currently starving there. It's choking on disease and sorrow. That's good. That's good. And we can help it along even more with choking on disease and sorrow. Yeah. Yeah, I like that. That's good. That's good. That's good. I don't think we need to get the city power, actually. That's bad. You need an aqueduct. And then you need a grocer. Oh god, I'm gonna have to micro these cities. Maybe I'll do that off camera. I kinda don't feel like this right now. Effort, man. Fuck. I could build an ironclad. Yeah! What a great idea! I don't want to give power because the cities, if they're already choking that much, I just don't want them to completely starve out. The AI will sometimes do this. They really love industrialization, but they might actually end up starving out their cities. I've seen it before. They fucking love to do that. Some of my cities don't even... You know... I'm tempted to just fucking automate all the cities, but I do kind of want more military units out of them. So I won't. I'll be taking that from you, boss. Thanks. So, friend. Yeah, okay, I'll take your city. How about no? How about not try to trick me with your lies? I want these things. Okay. How about these things? These things? You are asking for a total annihilation here. I'm just throwing that out there, boss. Seen a whole lot of really? Really? Huh. But you'd give me the trash. Democracy? I'll take it. It has been it's a tech. The democracy. It didn't sow the unhappiness. We're swapping out of slavery. All the others that have been tried. Just so I can start having happier cities now. Nah, we're fine. These two cities really are not worth my time. This disgusting putrescence, though, is... What the shit is this? Sounds like you're cruising for annihilation, Babylon. Yuck. Disgusting. I know, emancipation in 1886. Not bad, not bad. I could have probably adopted a few other things, too, but I think I'm gonna stay at war, so, you know. We have some trade ships, but unfortunately no one really wants to trade with us. Who would actually trade with us? It's a pity. We got assembly line on some people, but that's not gonna hold true for very long. Alright, you're dead to me, Siri of Armin. Mantamusa, Hammurabi. Good fucking luck establishing an espionage advantage on him. Yeah, right. So, Mansa Musa gave up his pursuit for culture. I've got more than half of the world's population, but I still need 24% of the land area in order to win this. That will have to be a project, though, for the next time. I'm glad that I was able to sit down and do this, despite all the interruptions and failures and tragedies and travesties. I feel good. I feel good. I'm glad I was able to do as well as I did in that war with Bacall. This victory is not guaranteed. It's going to take some more time. But Grimus in a strong position. And I guess I'll probably end up resolving this through military instead of just using my 33 cities to grind out something, because it would only be a matter of time until I caught up with the AI. I have too many fucking cities. Even though several of them are along cultural borders and would flip and don't have much in the way of room, I have too many cities. Kubla is dead. Korea is kicked to the curb. Pakal's kicked to the curb. And Surya Varman's been kicked to the curb. They are not a threat for this game. The two threats remaining are Babylon and Mansa Musa. That's not to say that the Khmer or the Mayans might not try and insert themselves into the action, because, I mean, hell, those Mayans now have 6 cities. Oh, 6. Shit. It's because I gave them that one. And look at how far out that culture expanded. I was just so busy fighting with other shit right now, I didn't want to do all that. But, you know, worst case, I'll just go punch that land out of them some other time. Some other time indeed. We could pump the culture slider, I suppose. Suppose. I don't think so, though. Turn 313, 62% done with all of the turns in the game. I did save, right? Yes. Okay. That will end up waiting for next Thursday, then. And I'll have to make sure I'll be updating the schedule for that. For folks who are still watching,